request you to deliver your session.
Thank you so much, Malini, for those kind words. I'm not very sure whether that vibrant thing really goes well, but it's an opportunity even to work in urban sector, which has so much of a relevance for public participation and taking off the grievances of the citizens. So that has that gives the arena for my presence in this workshop or a symposium. Delegates on the dais and my dear friends, good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Because I'm not seeing all of you as attentive as you should be. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm going to actually give you a quick picture of Telangana state, what we are doing in Telangana state. To start with, Professor Chari's lead was like very minimal, less than 3% municipal solid waste is being disposed of safely. That is the crux of a problem that I am trying to explain in this or present to you. If you look at the improper or unscientific disposal of solid waste, it has a very serious impact on water and sanitation sector. Do you agree? In fact, there is also a great opportunity for you to participate and bring your minds together and work for improving this situation in Telangana. If you look at Telangana state, we are actually last year we had 73 urban local bodies and we have added another 68. Yesterday we completed the elections for all municipal bodies in Telangana. Now we are 140 strong urban local bodies in Telangana. And the population that you are looking at, which have definitely improved upon our municipal solid waste disposal. If you look at the waste, I'm not going to read out the slides, but if you look at the actually what is optimal and where are we now, the gray is where is the optimal or the objective and the green is where we are. So in terms of segregation, in terms of door-to-door collection, we are almost 98%. We are there, 100%, near to 100%. But when it comes to segregation, it is low. And the processing is still where there is a lot of opportunity to work. And we are also looking at how much of dry waste processing is going on. Lot of advancements and activities have been taken where we introduced the owner and driver come owner scheme where the complete transportation of solid waste has been lasting. In fact, there were also lot of opportunity for PET bottles to be converted into t-shirts. So PET bottles are something that is sought after. But how do we actually get to take the dry waste to the next level? So there has to be lot of thinking in terms of how to deal with the recyclables and also investments in the same. We brought in to achieve this objective, we adopted the Municipal Solid Waste Management Rules 2016 in our state with a strategy also. How do we achieve this end result of having a zero garbage or going to the landfills, except for the inerts, what can be done? So the strategy is in place for all the municipalities, the action plans are in place, DPRs have been prepared, and we have city sanitation plans for all 140 municipalities, where we have made a detailed analysis of how much is the waste, what is the kind of the waste, what is the waste characterization, how much is wet, how much is dry, and then work on, if it is dry waste, I told you about the line that we can follow. In terms of wet waste, waste to compost is a thing which we all encourage. But then as it is now, we are involving the communities and doing it manually or with some semi-mechanization. But there's also great opportunity for waste to compost, which can be taken up and on a larger scale. In fact, in this context, we are also working on setting up a sanitation fund with the Urban Poverty Mission so that the self-help groups or the institutional mechanism that we have in MEPMA is going to be one of the opportunities to actually source or to attract investments as well as CSR, and then work it out how we can actually transact the same in wet waste and get it to the scale. This is just not for wet waste, but even for recyclables also, this can be a great opportunity for investments as well as to take it forward. With regard to what has been done, if there are a number of interventions that already have gone in Telangana, where remediation of dump sites are being taken up. We have legacy dumps, especially in smaller municipality as well, like Karimnagar, where the dump site is actually on the upper reaches of Lower Banner Dam, which is the drinking water source for the town. So we are looking at how can we do the remediation, what technologies are there. So already some work has gone in, and under the Smart City program also this work is being taken. Similar is the case with Warangal, where for the remediation some activity has gone in. And for Khammam also we have identified. So we are looking at how do we remediate the existing legacy dumps and also take proactive steps so that we do not create dumps for the future generations. So that activity is being done. And administratively also we have given a lot of special officers, we have trained the masons, we have Swachh autos in place, we have DRCCs in almost all municipalities, and we have identified the hotspots, and as I told you, we also have the city sanitation plans in place, and we have so this is basically to tell you that these are the areas where you can actually invest your ideas, as well as maybe if you would like to put in some money, or if you would like to look at attracting some investors who would like to invest in where there are impacts, especially in green projects. So the arena is available to you. I'm not going to take much of a time because Professor Chari is looking at my face and asking me, can you not close it now? I have one more opportunity tomorrow in one of the panel discussions where we can go into the details. But 2 points that I would like to reiterate. Number one, we have the readiness to work on scientific disposal of solid waste. We have the plans in place. Then we worked on a mechanism for sanitation fund so that we can actually take it forward from there. So the opportunity is very much available for brilliant minds sitting here in this August gathering to put your minds together and see that how best we can take it forward. And also for those who are having pockets or who would like to actually invest the CSR or impact investing, it is a right opportunity, a right place to invest in Telangana. Thank you very much.